We all love snuggling up, popping on Netflix, and watching a good old-fashioned rom-com.
Tell me about your day.
No, I want the hot, glistening bodies to zap away my brain and my day.
It's a pretty hard-to-beat formula, and a key part of that formula is the meet cute, which is where two lovers have to meet, and it's usually pretty cute. So cute that we've decided to make a list of our favorites. So buckle up, as these are some of the best meet cute moments on Netflix.
Hey!
To start us off, we have the ridiculously charming Lara Jean and Peter from To All the Boys I've Loved Before. In this classic meet-cute, we see Lara Jean almost literally knock Peter head over heels, but luckily for her, he takes it pretty well.
Good thing I'm wearing my helmet.
Hi.
Hi.
How you doing?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You know, people usually check behind them before they reverse, you know, to avoid killing others. It's a thing we do.
Yeah. Well, I'm just not completely comfortable with using my mirrors yet, so.
Yeah, clearly. Do you think you're gonna be able to make it out of the parking lot, or?
Yeah. We're fine. Really, seriously. So you should just go, seriously.
Sure. Whatever you say, Cubby. Hey, you are in charge.
Who is that?
That was Peter Kavinsky.
What are we waiting for?
We're waiting for the rest of the cars to leave.
When a film's premise is actually about being stuck in a romantic comedy, it's only expected that it has to have its own meet-cutes. With a cheeky wink to the convention, it begins with Natalie breaking up a separate couple's meet-cute before bumping into Josh.
What? You just busted through that potential new couple back there. Yeah. They were about to have a moment, that spark was there, and you just lowered your shoulder and plowed through them like a linebacker.
Stop being an idiot, all right? Oh. Have you been working out?
I have, yeah.
That was,
yeah,
that's
quite
hard.
I got an ab blaster.
Yeah.
This film could possibly be the reigning champion of meet cutes, as our lead character Henry makes countless first impressions with Lucy, a woman suffering from short-term memory loss.
You know, why don't you try this? It's kind of a hinge.
Now, why didn't I think of that?
Well, you're too close to the project. Don't be hard on yourself.
You're right. Sometimes you need an outsider's perspective.
Fresh eye never hurts.
When you stick two people as beautiful as Scarlett Johansson and Bradley Cooper in a supermarket queue together, it's only natural that sparks will fly. And that's what happens in He's Just Not That Into You.
Congratulations, you won.
What?
Our funky fall promotion. You're our 1,000th customer this month.
Are you kidding me?
I don't do kidding.
Oh my God, I never won anything before. And this is the most exciting thing that ever happened to me. Is that sad?
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, thank you, come here.
Oh. Wow.
We all love a romantic airport scene, but standing on a conveyor belt holding a sign written lipstick isn't the most conventional meet-cute. However, it does work the charm in Friends with Benefits.
Can you hand me my bag?
Sure. Which one?
The one with the strap.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Welcome to New York, sir.
Okay. Excuse me.
Yeah.
That's me.
Which one, the blue or the yellow?
No, the makeshift sign made out of lipstick. That's me.
You're Dylan Harper.
I am.
I'm Jamie Rellis.
You're picking me up from the airport.
Hi. Yes, I am.
King of the meet-cute, Noah Centineo, makes another appearance on this list in The Perfect Date, where he plays Brooke, a college student who offers to be Celia's stand-in date in order to finance his Ivy League dreams.
Good evening. I'm
Reese's bitch.
Celia, relax. He knows I'm kidding. Right, Slim?
Well, sweetie, you look so beautiful.
I'm not wearing the shoes,
but they go.
Listen to yourself.
Well, I happen to think that heels are an outmoded display of female oppression.
Fine.
Thanks, Mom. Let's do this so we can stop doing this.
You kids have fun.
Thanks for the assist back there.
Yeah, no, it's just part of the job.
Uh-huh. You are.
Aw, that's cute. but I can open my own doors.
There's a bit of a clue in the title, but when Sally offers to give Harry a lift to New York, they have a classic meet-cute moment, if not on a bit of the awkward side.
Oh, hi, Sally. Sally, this is Harry Burns. Harry, this is Sally Albright.
Nice to meet you.
You want to drive the first shift?
No, you're there already. You can start.
Back's open. Call me.
I'll call you as soon as I get there.
Oh, call me from the road.
I'll call you before then.
I love you.
Love you.
Sorry.
Parties are the perfect setting for the start of a romantic relationship, and When We First Met shows us how it's done with this endearing first encounter between Noah and Avery.
Are you okay?
God, I think so.
You are A League of Their Own, right?
Yeah.
I love that movie.
Okay, what character am I?
I'm getting like a Tom Hanks vibe from you. No?
No, I'm Dottie Hinson. I'm Gina Davis's character.
Okay, that makes more sense.
Are you my lesbian cousin Shannon?
Yes, I was gonna ask if you wanted to join my softball team.
I have a second guess.
Who?
Are you Garth?
Excellent. You know, the key to doing a good Garth impression is to make your mouth into a tiny little butthole.
That was good.
Noah.
I'm Avery. It's nice to meet you.
Sticking with the theme of parties, Natalie Portman and Ashton Kutcher play Emma and Adam in No Strings Attached, two old friends who reunite at a party 10 years after first meeting at summer camp.
I know you.
Hi, Adam Franklin of Camp Weehawken. I'm Emma Kurtzman. You tried to finger me?
Whoa! Yeah, wow! What do you go here? What are you doing
no,
at a party
I go to,
of frat?
I go to MIT, but I have this family thing, and I grew up in Ann Arbor.
MIT? Wow, so you grew up to be a lot smarter than me.
Yeah, sometimes my neck gets sore.
Why?
Because my brain's so big.
Meet-cutes don't get much smoother than when date Dr. Hitch swoops in to save Sarah from a painfully eager guy at the bar. It's ice cool and hard not to dream that someday you could pull off a move like this.
Are you always so shut down and afraid that the right man might make you feel like
a natural woman? Sorry I'm late, honey. I couldn't get a cab. How was the meeting?
Oh, well, there was a beginning, a middle, and an end. Nice to meet you, Chip.
Now, on the one hand, it is very difficult for a man to even speak to someone that looks like you. But on the other hand, should that be your problem?
So life's kind of hard all around.
Ah, university. The perfect time for lovers to meet. When sorority queen Elle is having a tough time adjusting to life at Harvard, the charming Emmett steps in to offer useful advice.
Swoon.
Excuse me, are you okay?
Yeah. Did I just put you on the spot like that, like all the time?
The professors? Yeah, they tend to do that, Socratic method. See, speak up in Callahan's class, he really likes people that are opinionated.
Okay.
And in Royalton's class, try to get a seat in the back. He tends to spit when he talks about products liability. And for Leventhal, you know, make sure you read the footnotes, because that's where he gets a lot of his exam questions from.
Right. Wow. I'm really glad I met you.
Not knowing who LeBron James is may prove to be a bit of an awkward moment when you're in the middle of an interview to be a sports doctor. If you don't laugh, you'll cry in this cringe-inducing first encounter between Amy and Aaron.
Can you validate my parking, please?
I don't validate. You should talk to Cheryl.
Okay. All right. Take care. Nice meeting you.
Bye, LeBron. Right. Thanks, buddy.
Cheryl, can you validate my parking, please?
Tall.
Yeah, I know, right? Do you know who that was?
The basketball player.
He was LeBron James. He's kind of like the basketball player.
Oh, yeah. I think I saw one of his soda commercials.
Yeah. Do you follow sports?
Oh my God, sports, I love them.
Who are your favorite teams?
The Orlando Blooms.
Although this legendary meet-cute may have influenced the creepy behavior of Joe from you.
Hello, do you work here?
Guilty.
It's hard to deny that the bookstore isn't the perfect place to meet a potential love interest, especially if said bookstore is run by Meg Ryan.
My dad gets me all the books I want.
Well, that's very nice of him.
Oh, that's not my dad, that's my nephew.
You know, I don't really think that he could be your nephew.
No, it's true. Annabelle is my aunt. Isn't that right, Aunt Annabelle?
Uh-huh. And Matt is...
Oh, wait, let me guess.
His brother!
We are an American family.
Before Charlie and Harper try to set up their bosses for a forced meet-cute in Set It Up, guess what happens? They unwittingly have their own meet-cute in a heated introduction trying to organize lunches.
Sir, there are two dinners, one for me and one for her, so we could split it, okay? I can take one to my boss and you can take one to yours, please. This is DEFCON 5.
You know DEFCON 5 is a good one, right? It's when everything's safe, international travel's fine.
DEFCON 1, you know what I mean.
What are the meals?
Okay, I'm gonna take her the truffle mac and cheese, and you can have the burger.
Are you insane? I'm not gonna give him a plain hamburger. It's a man of taste.
Okay, I'm gonna fix this, okay? See what I'm making? It's a truffle cheeseburger with kale. This burger could win awards.
Who says meet cutes only have to be for adults? In this adorable scene from Always Be My Maybe, Marcus heads over to Sasha's to offer her some dinner.
You want some soup? My mom said to ask if you wanted some soup. She makes way too much. Then I have to bring the leftovers to school in a thermos. Nobody wants to sit next to that kid with the thermos soup. Only the other kids with the thermos soup. And I don't want to sit next to those losers. Just kidding. What if I really did that? I thought you just did that. I thought you just shut the door in my face. I did, to be funny.
You can check out all these meet-cute moments now streaming on Netflix.